chapter 3 and square root chapter, and our next topic is to find the square root of fractions and decimals. First we will find the square root of the fractional numbers. Square root of fraction. Suppose a fraction is A upon B. And we have to find the square root of A upon B. This is our question. How we will find the square root of the fraction? First we will find the square root of the numerator A. Calculate square root A separately and square root B separately. After calculating square root A and square root B, then write down their values in the form of fraction. So square root A upon square root B, its value will be our answers. Now we are taking an example to find the square root of a fractional number. Let us find the square root of 39 1 upon 16. First multiply 16 and 39, you will get 624. Then add 1 also, 624 plus 1 upon 16 means 625 upon 16. This is the process of changing mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now our fraction is in the form of A upon B. Now we will find the square root of numerator and denominator separately. Square root of 625 separately, square root of 16 separately. Now square root of 625. Prime factorization. Five to the 10, 5 to the 5, 5. So square root of 625 is, after forming the pairs, 5 into 5. And in the same way, we know that square root of 16 is 4. So our answer is 25 upon 4, but we have to write down our answer in mixed fraction form because our question was in mixed fraction form. So in mixed fraction form, our answer will be, you have to divide 25 by 4. 4 6 are 24. 1 remainder, 6, 1 upon 4. So 6 1 upon 4 is the square root of 39 1 upon 16. Okay students, now after calculating the square root of fractional number, now we come to the square root of decimal number. How we calculate the square root of decimal number? There are some steps. Step number 1, write गिवन डेसिमल नंबर मेक पेयर्स ऑफ नंबर्स नंबर्स देयर मीन्स डिजिट्स आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट इन दिस सेकेंड स्टेप इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेक द कंप्लीट पेयर आफ्टर डेसिमल पॉइंट यू हैव टू पुट समटाइम्स जीरो आफ्टर द डेसिमल पॉइंट सो पुट जीरो इफ नीडेड एट लास्ट इफ नीडेड We had to put zero only in that case where complete pairs are not formed. When we have complete pairs of the numbers, then you have to apply the same method, long division method, to find out the square root. Using division method. Find the square root and our fourth step is put decimal point after half of the number of digits from right side. And in fourth step we will get our final answer. Now we will take an example. Now we will take an example of decimal number to find this square root and we will illustrate these steps while finding out that square root. Now take a decimal number to find the square root and we will follow up these steps also. The number is 156.25. Write the given decimal number which we have written now and then make pairs after the decimal point. Here after the decimal point we have already one pair forming by the two digits 2 and 5 and 0 is not needed. 0 is only needed in that case when there are odd number of digits after the decimal point. Now we will come to third step. We will use now long division method to find out the square root. Instead of speaking multiplication table, speak square, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square. Here we have to take 1 square, 1 1 the 1, and brought down the pair which is 56, here add 1 and 1 which is 2. Now put 1 after 2, multiply it by same digit 21, 1 the 21 which is quite less than 56, then put 2, 22 multiply by 2 which is 44, subtract. Here add 22 and 2, which is 24. And now brought down the next pair. We know that 5 comes when we multiply 5 by 5. So put here digit 5 and multiply it by 5. 5 into 5, 25, carry over 2, 5 for the 20 plus 2, 22, carry over 2, then 5 to the 10 plus 2, 12. Now we have done up to step number 3. Now we have to put the decimal point after the half number of digit. In our question, the decimal point is after 2 digits from right side. And in our answer, we have to put the decimal point after half number of digits, means half of 2 means 1. We have to put the decimal point after 1 digit from right side. So square root of 156.25 is 12.5. Okay, students.